In this video, we focus on an example of a car speeding up from rest. We learn to plot the motion on a velocity time graph, and then we quantify how fast the car is speeding up, and that's called the acceleration. Finally, we plot the motion on an acceleration time graph, and we learn to interpret the signed area bounded by that graph. So in our example, we're told that a car speeds up from rest, starting from the origin, and gets to 100 miles per hour in 10 seconds. The motion is always in a straight line, and the car speeds up at a constant rate. So in part A, we want to plot the motion of the car on a velocity time graph. And a point on this velocity time graph, of course, has two coordinates. The first one is what time is it in seconds? And then the second coordinate is what's the velocity in miles per hour? So if I look at a time of t equals zero, I'm told that the car was at rest at that moment in time. And I get my first point on the velocity time graph. It's just the origin because the car was at rest when we started the clock. The only other point we know is that when t is equal to 10 seconds, the velocity is going to be positive 100 miles per hour, and the grid spaces in the vertical direction, we're going to take those to be 10 miles an hour each. There's the plus 50 miles per hour for reference, and there's 100 miles per hour. So again, we know the car is moving at plus 100 miles per hour when t is equal to 10 seconds. That's our second ordered pair that we know on the graph. Finally, we're told that the car speeds up at a constant rate. And this means we can connect those two points with a straight line. The car is speeding up uniformly. In part B, we're asked to compute the slope of this graph and then comment on the physical meaning of that slope. So we look at the rise and the run. And the rise here, the change in the vertical coordinate, is plus 100 miles per hour. And the run, that's the change in the horizontal coordinate, is plus 10 seconds. So I get the slope and I'm careful to keep the units on this. And rather than trying to smash together the time units here, I think it's most intuitive to just keep it as 10 miles per hour per second. And so all this means is that as the car is speeding up, it's speeding up by 10 miles per hour every time 1 second goes by. And certainly we can see this in the graph. It starts from rest, and then I go over 1 second and up 10 miles per hour. And after 1 second, it's moving 10 miles per hour. After another second, it's moving 20 miles per hour. After another second, 30 miles per hour, and so on. So every time a second goes by, this thing speeds up by 10 miles per hour. And that's what 10 miles per hour per second means. And the name for a rate of change in velocity is the acceleration. And we get our first major fact of this video. And this lives in a box because it's so important. The slope between two points on a velocity time graph gives you the average acceleration. Next, we're asked to plot an acceleration time graph for the same car, and we're using those same units of acceleration of miles per hour per second for the car, just because those were very natural units for the context. And so for every moment in time, we want to plot the acceleration, but that acceleration was always the same number. It was 10 miles per hour per second. So with the value of acceleration always being the same, no matter what time it is, this is a horizontal graph, and it will extend all the way to when t is 10 seconds. And there's the plot of our acceleration as a function of time. And then in part B, we're asked to compute the area bounded by this graph and then comment on the physical meaning of that area. So the area bounded by this graph is just the area of this square, but we need to be careful to keep the units here. And the height of the square is 10 miles per hour per second. And the width of the square is 10 seconds. When I compute the area, the seconds cancel, and this gives me 100 miles per hour. And that's positive because this acceleration is above the t-axis. It's a positive acceleration. So what did that give us physically? That was the change in velocity for the car as it was accelerating. It went from 0 to 100 in 10 seconds. And this gives us our second major fact of the video. And we'll give this guy a box as well. The area bounded by an acceleration time graph gives you the change in the velocity. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.